Hey, what's going on, guys? It's your boy ProGammar here, and today, guys, it's right, today, not tomorrow, but today we are back with another video. And for today's episode, we are continuing our Let's Play of the game, Life is Strange Before the Storm. This is episode number 18, guys. Now, in the last episode, basically what ended up happening is we ended up finishing off the series. So, yeah, that happened. But as you guys know, in Life is Strange games, there are multiple endings. So I figured I'd come back and make another video, like, to show you guys the other ending. And then also, when I tried to, it turns out that you can't just, like, pick a part of a chapter to start in. You have to play the whole chapter over again. So, I've played about 6 hours, or another 6 hours of Life is Strange to get back up to this point. So that I can make this video for you guys. So, in other words, I've pretty much now played it twice so that I can get all of the endings for you guys. Now, this idea also, I remember I did it last, I did this idea last year as well. Well, I think it was about last year I uploaded the ending to Life is Strange the original Life is Strange. I'm sorry, guys, I'm a little bit tired today, so I'm a little bit confused. Anyway, I think it was about a year ago I probably uploaded the end of the last Life is Strange game. Now, I got that idea from Chameleon. As you guys know, I've recorded a ton of videos with him. But I'm thinking of maybe making this episode a little bit more like the YouTuber Swing Point, if you've seen him before. He does, like, plays a lot of, like, Telltale type games, like, you know, Batman and stuff like that, and, like, Walking Dead. But he'll show, like, all the differences and stuff in the games. But yeah, so I want to do something a little bit like him, where I actually show all three endings. I'm going to hopefully show you guys both the secret ending, where Rachel gets to go see her mother, Sarah. Then, I guess, one of the other normal endings, where, I guess, you tell Rachel the truth. And then the ending we did in our Let's Play, where we told, Rachel a lie, to hopefully make her feel a little bit, I guess, you know, to be able to hopefully live a happy life. Anyway, I'll probably show you guys that decision again as well later on in the video. But anyway, guys, yeah, I kind of played, like I said, a lot of Life is Strange to get up to this point. So the first ending that I'm going to show you guys is going to be the ending where we tell Rachel the truth. So I'll show you guys that ending now. When I went back and did that Let's Play, this time I actually caught Elliot, like the police actually came and, like, you know, locked him away kind of thing. So that ended up happening. I decided to actually do that to see what, like, that impact would be as well, which I actually have seen what that does. But you guys hopefully haven't seen it by now, so hopefully you guys will enjoy it. So yeah, guys, anyway, let's stop talking about it and let's get straight into it. All right, guys, so we're back up to this point in the game. So this is going to be the first difference check we do. So when we did our original playthrough, we protected Rachel from the truth. And this time we are going to tell Rachel everything, except this isn't going to be the secret ending. This is just going to be, I guess, the normal ending for this game, where we just tell Rachel the truth. Or tell her everything, and she doesn't meet her mother, Sarah. So, yeah, let's see what happens. And, well, I guess, like it kind of says, I guess we're telling her everything. Man, that'd actually be shocking to find out, though. That'd be terrible. Don't even know how you'd react to that. Yeah, yep, might want to wait outside. Probably not the best time to come in. Yeah. Things are not going too well. Hey, James, sorry. You probably shouldn't have done what you did, though. Like, come on, that was pretty uncalled for. Now I guess she just feels betrayed by her father. Who she literally not long ago, I guess, like, you know, going back, I guess, a little bit in the episode, said that she felt trusting around. So what happened to Rachel then? Has she run off? He's annoyed. I don't know how he's not in jail. Because, you know, the attempting to get someone murdered kind of thing usually ends up with someone going to jail. Like, I don't think he should just be there, but, you know. Okay, so the thing with Frank seems to be the same. And Pompadour! Ah, Pompadour's back. And he's a puppy still. Like, I guess he wouldn't really change much in a day, but... You know, guys, in the original game, he's like a fully grown dog. Fully grown dog. Oh, man. Anything else change? Okay, so I think most of this is the same. So unless some of these cutscenes change depending on some of the decisions you actually make in the game, like, unless you can somehow ruin their marriage, but I don't think so. Which, that'd be a pretty evil thing to do. Like, that would not be nice at all, so I'm glad at least we got that ending. And yeah, this time, because in this, like, let's play of the episode, I end up catching Elliot, and, you know, the police end up catching him, so this time he's, I guess, getting expelled from Blackwell. And he's still got his sling on. Why can't we play the game? I like playing with Mikey. And Drew. And, what's the other name? Oh, I'm so sorry, I forgot your name. I'm sorry, I haven't played this game in a little while. It's not Stella, is it? Maybe? I don't think that's right somehow. I just don't think that's right somehow. Okay, so I think most of this is the same as, like, the ending we got. I think. Yeah, we're gonna catch around again. Time number two. Yeah, you'll probably see that again later on. Just wait a minute, you know. You can probably just wait out there. It'll probably be like 10 minutes, you know. And here we are, back at the lighthouse. At least we're happy together. Well, we're mostly happy. But at least we got her back. So I think that's it. I think that's all the changes so far. Yeah, so I think that's all the changes there actually are for that, like, I guess, choice. So not really too different. I guess it really just depends on, like, a lot of the other choices you actually make in the game. Not too much really changed, I guess, apart from the whole Elliot thing, because I kind of changed that one. And then, I guess, only the real other change is, like, I guess, the hospital scene and, like, the house scene at the start. I was thinking maybe a little bit more would change, but I guess not. So what I'll probably do, guys, now is I'll probably go back and show you guys the decision I made during my Let's Play. And that will be the ending where we protect Rachel from the truth. So I'll show you guys that ending, and then once I'm done with that ending, or once that's through, I'll probably cut back to this screen, and then I guess I'll show the next ending, or the secret ending anyway. In this case, is what Sarah thinks is best for Rachel. I'm sorry, Rachel. I'm gonna protect Rachel from the truth.
What's wrong? I failed you. I couldn't find her.
Sorry, Rachel.
I'm so sorry. Funny. You seemed so confident. I really thought you'd find her.
Yeah. Me too.
Maybe we can try tomorrow. Maybe she hasn't left town yet.
Of course. I know wherever she is, she loves you very much.
Just about, I guess, trying to do what's best for Rachel.
Do you know that?
Just mention the letter, maybe.
Because
she said everything.
Why should she be any different from the rest of us?
She has a point there as well. I'm sorry, Rachel. It's what your mother wants, and I want to do what's best for you. Thank you. Trophy earned, all the devils are here. Trophy earned before the storm. Damon was Frank's friend after everything Damon did. Frank was such a good guy. Thank you, Frank. David's bringing home flowers for Mother's Day. And he's asking Joyce to marry him. At least everyone's happy. Well, I know it's tough for Chloe, but hopefully everyone can just start over and just, you know. Sorry, Elliot. Mikey Sling, with his armor on. And even Drew's playing Dungeons and Dragons. Nathan. It's quite cute. Everyone deserves someone. At least those two, like, you know, found each other. Whether that's as friends or more. And we're back. And so's Rachel! Glasses out now. See you, Mr. Wells. Man. And we're at the lighthouse. And there's the crow. I guess these two, at least, they're either BFFs, like they're like the best of friends, or they make a very cute couple. So they just stay together as a cute couple. And the crow flies off. I'm guessing the crow was like James's spirit animal. Alright guys, so yeah, so that was to protect Rachel from like the truth ending. We kind of have seen that one, I guess, during our original playthrough. Now the last one I'm going to do is... It has a little bit of a setup to it. So if you guys remember when I did my original Let's Play, I said to you guys that I had originally taken like the bracelet from Rachel when we got the choice to either get a tattoo, kiss Rachel, or take the bracelet. So during our original Let's Play, we end up taking the bracelet, but then I end up going back and, you know, replaying the episode and changing it to kiss Rachel, right? So for this one to work, for it to work easier, you actually need to take the bracelet unless at the end of the game you have to pick all the right text options, but this way seems a bit easier, so what I'll probably do is I'll probably go back and show you guys the scene from that where we actually take the bracelet from Rachel. I guess see what she says, and then I guess I'll cut to the next part of the setup, which is actually when we speak to Sarah. So, yeah, I guess I'll cut back then, guys.
Rachel, stop.
Chloe doesn't want to go through with this, does she?
You don't mean this. It's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life. Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
Your bracelet, a tattoo, or a kiss? Interesting. I guess a bracelet is her prized possession kind of thing. A kiss, okay, maybe that's going a bit too quickly. Like, they've been hanging out for 2 days. A tattoo? See, I would go with a kiss or a tattoo, but I think a bracelet's something that's, like, really important. Something that's, like, I don't know, kind of sentimental to her, I guess, in a way. But I think it's something like if that she gave us a tattoo, gave us her bracelet, maybe they'd be like, you know, maybe she'd go along with it.
Give me something I can hold. Something solid that'll remind me what you promised.
Okay, like what?
How about your bracelet?
This bracelet?
Yeah.
I haven't taken it off, ever. My dad said I wore it home from the hospital, if you can believe that. I don't know why, but it's always reminded me that the world is a lot bigger than Arcadia Bay.
The perfect thing to give me, you better keep it. You know, it is something important to her, so let's just let her keep it.
You better keep it. It sounds really important to you.
It is. Which is why, of course, I'm going to give it to you.
But we just said you could keep it.
Okay. I need your help untying this.
We really have to be, like, just randomly out in the middle of a random road? Couldn't we be anywhere else? What about, like, our car in the junkyard or something, maybe?
I will leave you a little more now.
Only a little, huh? What if I said let's leave tonight?
Really?
Fire in the background.
What?
Now we got snow. Why is weather always weird in these games?
It's obviously a sign. So? What do you say? Let's go sneak some clothes and stuff for my house.
For you or for me?
I gotta say, my clothes look damn good on you.
Cool. Let's do it.
And then, we'll get the hell out of Arcadia Bay.
Fuck yes.
Let's go! I thought you said you didn't really like fitness, Chloe. And now you're running? What's up, Chloe? Seems like something's going on with Chloe. Something doesn't seem right. Alright guys, so if you guys do want to get the secret ending where Rachel and Sarah actually meet, this scene, like, right here is a pretty important scene, so basically there are a lot of text options that come up, and you have to basically pick the right option all the way through the whole scene. If you don't get the right options, I don't know if you can get the ending. Luckily for us, we have the bracelet, so it should make it a lot easier to do. But there is a way you can actually do it if you don't have the bracelet. I actually have, like, a screen next to me that actually has the options on there. I'll probably flash them on screen for you guys can see them if you'd like to. And then I guess if you guys would like to do it, you can do it yourselves. I'll probably fast forward through this bit up until the bracelet part, because that's the one difference I'm going to make to, I guess, all the decisions I actually have to the left of me, which I guess will be on screen or to the middle of me now when I edit the video. Anyway, guys, yeah, so this is a pretty important scene for that. So I guess I'll make these options. I'll probably speed up this part for you guys and cut back when we get to the bracelet part. All right, guys, so we're actually up to the options screen now where we can actually give her Rachel's bracelet. So I think this is like an item that basically makes it guaranteed that Rachel and Sarah will meet as long as you pick the right ending. Apparently the options, I guess, I flashed on screen earlier, or should have flashed on screen, should give you, I guess, the outcome where that, you know, as long as you pick the right ending, Rachel and Sarah will meet. So although that is the case, I'm going to try this and give her Rachel's bracelet instead, and I guess see what happens from there. Considering I think she got the bracelet from Sarah anyway. Yep. Everything comes full circle. See you, Sarah. Alright, so I guess not too much really changed from there, and then I guess now I'll just cut back when we get to the final decision. Alright guys, so now that we got back to this ending screen again, to I guess basically finish everything off so that Rachel and Sarah can finally meet, the final decision we have to make at the end of the game is to tell Rachel everything, so this is I guess the secret ending to Life is Strange, guys, so yeah, let's I guess stop talking about it, and let's get straight into it, guys. Alright guys, so far leading up to this point, nothing has really changed, like, everything's basically been the same. So, this is going to be interesting to see how this scene goes. Because I think this is a scene where it's actually, like, they're meant to meet. Sarah! She came! And Rachel finally got to meet her mother. Her real mother. Glad to see they actually got to meet in the end. Well, so not that her, you know, other mother wasn't a good person, but, you know. She still just wanted to meet her real mother. Alright guys, so that was the ending to the game. That was, I guess, all three endings, including the secret ending, so... Yeah, they're kind of interesting. I guess they didn't really change too much. I think it just depends on a lot of the decisions that you actually make throughout the whole game. So I think depending on the decisions you've made throughout all of the episodes will depend on, I guess, the entire ending you get, like Mikey and stuff playing, you know, Dungeons and Dragons and stuff like that. So maybe some of that will change depending on what you do. I'm not too sure, but anyway, so that's all the main endings. So I hope you guys did enjoy the video. This will probably be the final episode for Life is Strange before the storm that I post on the channel. So I hope you guys have enjoyed it. I hope you guys have enjoyed this series. And yes, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you did like it, please like, comment, and subscribe. Also, for those of you who are interested, I've set up a channel Twitter account and a channel discussion, which I'll link in the video description below. So thank you guys so much for watching this video and this series, guys. And I'll see you in the next video of the next series, guys. See ya!